Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a painting of this piece right here. It's a fan art I did of the movie Wolfwalkers. It's a very interesting movie, and if you are a fan of cartoons like I am, I'll suggest you try checking it out. So I am not going to go over my sketching process for this piece. However, if the process of sketching is something that you'll be interested in, and I suggest you leave a comment below and I'll see what I can do about that. Okay, without talking much, let's get started. I already have a base color here, where you see all these grays and the textures. So I'm just going to create a layer above that. And so you don't need to worry about getting this kind of textured effects, because I'm going to be leaving a link to this, the lines. So if you are interested in painting it, you can download that and do your own painting as well. So let's get started. So first of all, I'm going to start with the flat colors like I usually do. So I'm creating a new layer. I'm starting with Mebh. Her name is actually very funny. So skin. Okay. And using the magnetic lasso tool, I just select all areas of our skin, fill them out. So I'm using the triadic color scheme because this covers like almost all the colors that I am going to be in this piece. Going to our hair now. So our hair has kind of like a dark orange color, a very deep orange color. Then going to the color of her dress. Her dress kind of has a kind of light, a less saturated green, but it's dark. A bit dark in color. Now her belt is also green, but it's less saturated and not as dark as the dress. So, okay, then these bands on her hands are brown. Dark brown. Okay. Now let's go to her eyes. So I'm going to come up. Or rather, one thing that's important to note is the eyes are not always white, like pure white. The eyes tend to take on the color of the environment that they are in. So I'm going to add a bit of brown tint to her eyeballs. Now for the eyeballs, her eyeballs are green in color. Not too dark, but not too light either. Okay. Now let's go to her lip. I made these characters a bit more mature, because they are actually kids in the movie, but because of some certain elements that I wanted to add to this piece, I had to make them look a bit more mature. So I hope I'll be pardoned for that. Dark or reddish brown lip. Then I'll see how that works. I think I'm liking how this looks, so let's go ahead and shade it. So now let's go into the mouth. Put the background below the lip layer. When I say the mouth, I mean I always combine the layer for the teeth, the tongue, and inner parts of the mouth together. So, start with our teeth. Our canine is already pronounced. I guess did that because of the character. Okay. For the tongue and the inner parts of the mouth. I'm going to be using kind of pink or red for the tongue. So now let's go to her earrings. She's got two golden earrings. Okay. So she's got leaves and flowers on her hair. So I'm going to paint those in. To tidy up this piece, there are some places where the colors are not really complete, like this part here. Tidy. Okay, now we can move on to the second character. For some reason, I can't remember her name. Between orange and yellow. So now let's go to her dress or her top. So this is a black, supposed to be a hood for the graphics cast. Graphic like drawing makes it look like a shawl. So this is completely black. Okay, so next we go to our shirt. Slightly darker than Mebh's shirt. These two of the arms of the shirt are going to be white. And her trousers will be dark color. She has blue eyes. So I might actually go off her color scheme here a little bit. I have to get eyeballs. So I'm going off the color scheme here a bit to get her lip colors. Like my hair has flowers on them, so I'm going to paint those in flowers and leaves. So take note that I'm only doing the flat colors for now. I'm not going into those major details. Those ones will come later on. Now for the bird, this guy two colors. And this guy here. have a dark brown and a very saturated brown. Okay, and that's the bird. So I want to start adding shadow and light. So for this piece, I'm going to imagine that, there are two sources of light. One has an orange light source coming this way, and maybe a blue light source coming this way. So let's see how that works, or how that will work. So catch some light. The light is coming from the other side. So I'm going to set this layer on. I'm experimenting at this point, so I'm going to set this layer on overlay and see how that works. Okay. I'm starting out with this one. Make it a clipping mask and set this on linear dodge. Let's see what it gives us. Okay, I think I'm liking this effect as well. Okay. Yeah, so that's for here. Notice I started with the lights in this for this piece. Normally I start with the shadows, but the shadows aren't going to be too pronounced for this piece, so I'm starting with the lights. Then we can go on later and add her shadows. So link it near dodge. Like I said, I am experimenting at this point. Like, I don't have a clear cut method that I'm following. I just apply colors that are within this range on the fly, and if it works, I settle for that one. You should also consider that when you are painting as well. Some of this color. To do shadows, add some little shadows to the lights here, a few areas of the paintings. So let's start with that. Thank you. it have a bit of purple tint in there. Just making these shadows to be more defined. We add shadows to the shirt and hair. To be leaving it at this. I'll do the final rendering of camera, but at least I've tried to paint up to this point, so you should get the concept now.
How's the wolf run free? The wolf will leap from child to sleep. The wolf will we'll go.